Hello, Ecto Sage here on the Sage Shell, and we are back for some more Singular Survival. And our plan for today is rather simply, well, let's first and foremost go ahead and fly up to the seat. Zoom out, make sure everything is connected, looks like all of our ships are docked and everything. Cool, let's go ahead and leave this area right here. Awesome, possum. Let's disable our inertial dampeners so we can just keep floating up a little bit away from the asteroid. Because we should have enough mined materials to do pretty much anything. So we're going to go ahead and do a few, well, rather silly things today that might cause kaboom and explosions, but I think should spice it up a tiny bit. We still have meteorites turned on and all of that, and speaking of which, laser defense grid. Let's just make sure that's turned on once again. Good, good, good. Still set to target meteorites and small ships and missiles. Actually, let's turn off missiles because I tested that and it missed. But we're also going to go ahead and point ourselves towards, if we can just remember where the button is, do we have a camera still attached somewhere here? Virus targeting camera, there we go. So we're going to go ahead and point this towards, if I can remember where the heck to aim it. Not our body location, not this, not even that, but the monolith that should be on Mars. And we're going to just start drifting towards Mars for X number of hours. And while we drift, I know we can do jumps, but while we drift, I'm going to try to fly about some of the ships and do some maintenance on us. So this means we're going to be using pretty much, there we go, aim ourselves up like that. We'll turn on our inertial dampeners again. Right, like so. There we go, inertial dampeners on. And now it should be pointed towards that. Let me just go ahead and check. Yes, we are indeed pointed towards that. Cool. And the ship has come to a stop, so let's hold spacebar, disable our inertial dampeners again, get ourselves up to maximum speed, and then we'll just start floating there. And as I was saying, while we're floating, we're going to get into the flying sausage and buzz about and try to repair and build up the ship some more. We still have a bunch of atmospheric thrusters that aren't finished. That's been driving some people crazy, so I'll work on those. And then I'm thinking we'll put in more solar panels as we go. And I'm figuring we're going to be floating for, you know, God knows how long, probably a very, very long time. I mean, it's way out there. So we won't really have to worry about running into the planet. Now, asteroids might be another thing, but I've done some tests in the past where I've thrown ships out at, well, immense speeds, even with, like, the maximum speed mods installed where it disables the maximum speed, and we've never hit anything while doing that, so I think we'll be fine just jetting out there into the stars at, oh, God knows what speed. Well, I guess at 120 or 110 meters per second or whatever it is that it stops at. Boy, our acceleration is not brilliant on this. We're probably going to need to upgrade our thrusters a lot before we try landing on Mars as well. Anyway, it looks like we're about up to speed. There we go. Leave our inertial dampers off. I'm going to go ahead and check our hydrogen tanks. And they're still pretty much full up, which is good. So let's hop out of there and go ahead and we'll do some work here. We're going to have to do all of this with our inertial dampers off, but I think it should spice things up a little bit anyway. Which one of these? You are pressurized. You should be depressurized then. Yes, and I need to put a need to go ahead and actually make sure I have my helmet on. There we go. And away we go out here. Cool. So this is going to be a very interesting thing, of course. Oh my, your inertial dampeners are still on. That could be very bad. Very, very bad. I mean, I'm tempted to go ahead and try to actually build like a smaller welding ship and use that, but let's not do that. Let's also go ahead, we need to disable our inertial dampers over here. By the way, you've probably seen me toggling on and off my jetpacks and stuff like that. That's because I'm still, I've been playing more Avorgian. Even when I'm not recording it, I've actually just been playing on my own, and well, let's just say I've gotten very used to its control scheme. Alright, so let's hop in here, and we'll first off go ahead and just try to weld up all of those, whatever those things are, the giant engines that I have lost the name of completely. So, landing gear's unlocked, fly ourselves up, do that a little bit to stop ourselves, cool. And this should be, you know, an interesting test of how the game handles us moving at relatively high speeds. Should be. And obviously the ship's, the whole big ship's not moving at maximum speed anymore because this little ship and the other little ship slowed it down a little bit while, you know, their inertial dampers were on. So let's go ahead, buzz up to this nice and slow-like. I'm going to have to remember it's all under manual control, so it's not going to be any aided slowing or anything. Oh, lag. A little lag there. Aim down a little bit. It's a good thing the inertial dampener, the gyroscopes still have auto stop on spin, or I'd really be trying quite a bit here. And our welder should be on. How close are we to this? The cool thing about with inertial dampers off is, yeah, you can just slowly drift towards things. So there we go. Got that on. That was actually not too hard at all. Let's go ahead and I think that's actually all the ones on this little platform. We'll go over to the next platform over there. And you see it's actually missing too, like completely missing. So let's get our ship drifting in that direction. Yes.
Yes.
Now remember, we're currently actually moving at 98 meters per second. This whole ship is skyrocketing through the stars. You can see in the background there's actually a little asteroid that's just moving on past. So we're moving. There's another one over there to the right now. Yikes. We're moving. We're just also trying to do, well, stuff basically like you would in proper space, where you'd be on your way to Mars or whatnot, and you could actually get out and move around the ship because you would be moving with it. Of course, if we turned our inertial dampeners on, we'd be in some serious trouble right now. All right, so let's go ahead. I think we're close enough right now to this. Let's go ahead and brake a little bit here. And we'll just leave this ship drifting just the tiniest little bit. That should be fine. Check our inventory. We're going to need some steel plates, because I'm pretty sure that's what it starts it. So there we go. Got our steel plates off of that. It's so funny without inertial dampers why we keep drifting. Get our number sevens in. I said number sevens. There we go. And we'll plop you in right here. Now the cool thing is, I could actually go ahead and turn off our jetpack if I line this up right. Come on. Down, jetpack off, there we go. And now our mag boots are actually turned on, so we're going to stick to the ground. Let's go ahead and line this up, and it's not lining up at all. What's going on here? There we go, now it's showing up. That was weird. Place you right. Wow, it's actually very difficult to place. There we go, there. It's like I had to go third person to even line it up correctly. Like, that should be the right spot, but it's... ooh, it's finicky, ain't it? There we go. It's just such a large block, and getting so close means it becomes very difficult. Anyway, I got those two, and I figure you're still drifting pretty close. Let's just go ahead and get all the other ones in place as well. And let's keep an eye on our hydrogen as well. Hydrogen and oxygen are still both decent. Oxygen's a little low. And I'll just make sure all these are placed in that way. When we hop into our flying sausage again, we can just go ahead and fly between all these lickety-split. There we go, it should be good. Yep, it's a little difficult when you can't see the top of it, make sure it's facing the right way. And one last one over here, which I overshot. Gonna have to take some getting used to flying like this, eh? I'm waiting for them. I was gonna say I was waiting for the moment when suddenly we hit a large asteroid, but instead that happened. And I don't know if you can hear it, but now my Focus Starlet, whatever the hell thing is, buzzing my audio like crazy. Alrighty, so there we go. Yeah, I had to restart my whole recording thing because obviously that Scarlet thing is a piece of flim. I did get a message from the guys who sell it on Amazon after I left a rather poor review. So I have to go ahead and answer that. I was thinking, well, maybe it'll just work because it's such a faff, especially if they're like, hey, go ahead and send it back to us and we'll send you another one. That means I don't have a functional system for, you know, a week while you do that. It's not exactly an ideal option. So that's why I haven't responded to them yet. My own folly, I guess. Anyway, flying out here, let's go ahead, high rock, and find out where we died and see if we can find our toolbox. Was it around here? I think it was around here, wasn't it? Or was it, Of course, the body location thing would be absolutely useless at this point. Because we're moving so quickly, the body location would have zipped away. In fact, we could even demonstrate that just to turn it on and show. Body location, show. Yeah, we've moved 6 kilometers. I was sort of hoping our backpack might have been carried along with the ship, but I'm not seeing it. So we'll have to get ourselves some new tools, lickety-split. At least we don't have to worry about the oxygen and whatnot we were talking about maybe being out of there for a minute. All right, so elite. How about elite tools? Coolio. Let's take one grinder, because you never know, sometimes you end up needing that, and one of you. Cool, drop the rest of you off in there. And then let's grab some iron, actually steel plates. At least we'll probably need a few more of those to start placing, and I think that'll be it for now. We'll leave off the oxygen tanks and all that. And let's finish putting the rest of these in. Oh, I think it was right here, actually, where we died. I seem to remember that, like, partially complete one. Anyway, buzz ourselves down here gently enough. And you guys saw, I didn't come in here at, like, Mach 3 or something. I came in here relatively slow. See, that looks too high to me if I place that, so I think we have to get a little bit closer. That looks better. There we go. Alrighty. And ta-da, all done here. And we got three more we need to place in over here. Ooh, that was actually a kind of close meteorite, that one. Meteorite asteroid. That one, far closer than I expected. Yeah. Alrighty. Got me sweating a little bit. If we do run into any massive troubles, I might be a bit of a stinker and just reset to our previous save. But of course, if we do that, one thing we are going to have to take into account is that I haven't saved while we're moving, because I don't want to save while we're moving. You know what? Screw it. I will. Control Shift, F5, Enter. Are you sure you want to quick save? Yes. Let's test this game. Let's test it and see if we can survive us saving here. So if something goes wrong and we load this, we'll find out if it just reloads a nightmare hellscape. You know, if everything's inertial dampers turn on and everything just blows up, or if it works. That is, if something goes wrong, we end up reloading. Aha! Anyway, we got all those in. Let's go ahead and fly back to the Flying Sausage, which, you know, I'm looking at it now. Well, we've been calling it the Flying Sausage forever, which, because it was sort of cylindrical, but we never actually colored it like a sausage. Sausage is a sort of, like, reddish-brown, you know? So let's see if we can get sort of a reddish-brown sausagey color. Like a hot dog, almost, is what I'm thinking of, aren't I? You know what we should do? We should Google sausage. Sausage party. No, thank you. Just sausage. And there. So, it's sort of a reddish-brown. That is kind of disgusting. That's more pink almost, but let's see, what color did we just got? That's sort of a beige, isn't it? It's not really red enough, so let's go a little bit more red. That's almost a pink. Ooh, come on. That'll have to do, I think. So yeah, the Flying Sausage is now going to be an absolutely hideous color. And you can't say I don't color things anymore, because I'm going to color it in. Actually, never mind. It's not working. Congratulations! The Flying Sausage has been saved from being colored into an ugly orange. Alright, well, let's just go ahead and take the Flying Sausage and continue to go ahead and try to weld these things up, and hopefully everything will go to plan. And we won't have any massive sudden disasters or game glitches that'll annihilate the entire universe. Everything should just work perfectly fine. Also, is there an atmosphere on Mars? I can't remember. I seem to remember there being a very, very light atmosphere on Mars. So I'm not even sure if these will help. we'll put more thrusters in proper before we land. The idea is, by the time we get to Mars, this ship should be much bigger and one hell of a monstrosity. Not that it's not a monster already, but just something that's just mind-boggling to the eyes. And of course the stats. I always like having stats that are like, this ship is 4 trillion mass and it makes no sense at all. Such things, eh? There we go, that's welding up. So, even though we couldn't color blocks, it looks like we can at least weld them up, which is a massive positive. That said, I think we might have just run out of materials. Let's buzz closer to our right, and we'll get near this other one and see what that does, eh? Hey, you gonna weld up? No? Not welding up, huh? That's weird. I would have at least expected that one to weld up a little bit. Nothing? Nothing at all? It's clearly in front of us. Alright, well, that's not exactly ideal. Alright, let's shut that off and see what we're missing here. Because we appear to be missing materials. The game's also frozen right now. Okay, it's responding in. That's great. Alright, so motors is what we're missing. Why didn't you at least weld it up more? Same with you. So we're missing motors and all that fun. So what we're going to go ahead and do is have some fun maneuvering the ship over to the docking area there. Lock ourselves in place and go ahead and try to get some more stuff. So this should be more interesting. So buzz this way, like proper spaceships, and start moving towards that. And I never did go ahead and put those interior lights, which you can now place on these ships, by the way. I never did install those onto it to give us a better sense of how far we are away from things. So we might not be doing the best landing ever here, but hopefully things will go to plan. Also, you can see I've gotten used to the controls again. I'm no longer pressing the Avorian keys and toggling on and off our landing stuff all the time. Anyway, here's our docking cam. Fingers crossed we don't come in too hot and hit anything. Maybe I'll slow us down a little tiny bit. Oh, nifty. I love it. And there's the word nifty again. Okay, coming down a little bit here. Gently now, gently. And up, 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 up. A little bit forward. Oh, and lock. Okay. Everything is fine. We did it. Okay, well, let's go ahead. Programmable block. Have you run? No, you haven't. So let's run you once. I said recompile, run. Cool, it ran, so that should fill up some of the cargo containers on our ship. Let's go to inventory. Let's go to main. Got magnesium just sitting in there. Do we have enough room to drop that off? Yes, okay. Let's go ahead to, might as well drop that off too. Find ourselves motors. So there we go, motors. We're gonna need a lot of those. It was like over 1,200, I think, per each. And let's go ahead and find sausage cargo. Oh, and someone said it's weird that I'm always using underscores for my naming things. That's because in college, I went to a college for game art. They suggested naming things with underscores or just no spaces at all and just using capital to signify the next word. And they did that because some programs just, they don't recognize a proper space as something. So, you know, the game engine or whatever will go ahead and try to read a file, and if it has a space in there, it just goes, I don't comprehend a, and it just, well, shits the bed, basically. So that's why I do that. It's just a habit I decided to keep for everything, because I figure, hey, it's a decent habit. Let's go ahead and actually just search up the word rotor motor. I always get those mixed up, don't I? There we go. Got all of you. Got you. Got you. Did I just take that from sausage cargo to sausage cargo? Son of a bitch. I did. Yep. Okay, so I guess we got all the motors we have. We might as well queue up some more, because we might end up needing them. So we'll queue up, what do you guys say? 3,000? Maybe 4,000. There we go. 4,000 motors. And that way we should hopefully have enough. So disconnect there. Go ahead and fly away. Nifty. And let's start welding up, and we should have some reasonable success now. Hopefully. Fingers crossed, eh? And of course, you know, still drifting and everything, but that shouldn't be too much of a problem. As long as we keeps our speeds low, we should be all right. And yeah, so far so good. Bring in gently enough, turn on our welders. I need to put some lights on this thing to give us an idea of distance, and also when they're on, just have a bunch of big reddish-orange lights to give us a heads up that, hey, be careful. Coolio, got both of those in. What the hell? Very odd that one of them turned on and one of them didn't. I guess maybe the one that didn't has been here a while, and the one that did is one that we just placed, so the one that's been, of course, shut off, and we shut the whole group of them off ages ago. Alrighty, coming on down here to this one. And we'll go ahead and weld you guys up as well. I like the fact that we're making progress towards the planet. You know, it's obviously very, very slow progress. Yeah, it must be what's going on with those. But it is progress nonetheless. And, it, you know, you get that little feeling of, like, something could go terribly wrong at any moment. Of course, I probably would reload if it was really, truly, just absolutely devastatingly wrong. But at least it adds a little bit of tension instead of saying the meteorites might come while they promptly hit some off-world base somewhere else that I'm nowhere near. Which is always a little bit weird that they do that. Especially when last time they were bombarding our spawn location where there was, well, nothing there. I love the asteroid in the background just slowly drifting by. It's like, oh, the world's alive! Ooh. Alright, so we got these last, what is it, 5 right here, and then I think we're done with these. And we can move on to those solar panel installations. And this should only take but a second, I think. There we go. Pop those two in. All right, and these are all the new ones, so they're going to be going spinning. Of course, in space, they got nothing, really, to go ahead and pull through them. But it is interesting to see them spinning up nonetheless. Let's get down here and weld you two up. And then I think we'll go back and... do we want to dock this ship again? Or do we want to just go ahead and leave it out here and just see what we need for solar panels first? I think that's what we'll do. We'll start putting in solar panels and see what we end up running short on. Okie dokie. And that's not good. That's really not good. Because if that's not welding up and that one didn't get finished, that means we don't have the supplies for that on this ship. So gotta figure out what we're short on. Let's go ahead and first and foremost stop this ship from drifting. There we go. pretty much match the speed of the main ship. And let's see, what do you have here? Oh, yeah, wait. Not again. It's like if you touch it, it can't even... It's like if you touch it, it counts it as, you're moving really, really quick. Like, let's test that. If I just touch you gently, no? You're not going to, like, punch me in the face? It's like the ship just all of a sudden realizes, oh, wait, I'm moving really fast and you just touched me. That way means you must have impacted me heavily, which of course means I'm terrified at the prospect of trying to use a land gear or something. Oh, by the way, let's go ahead really quickly and let's just open this door. And... did that pressurize this room? Almost. And let's open this one, so we should get vented out in space. It didn't happen. Okay, I thought it would be really cool to jettison us out there with our inertial dampers off, but that didn't happen at all. Alright, let's go ahead. Find that one over there. Coolio. How many motors can we hold on our own? Let's find out really quickly. We can hold 140 something, so it'll be at least 10 trips back and forth, which is an awfully long time. Also, I'm not seeing our backpack around here again, so let's assume... I mean, it could have gotten bumped upwards, but I'm not seeing it there, so let's assume it's gone. What else do we have? We're gonna just have to dock this again, aren't we? So let's once again do the procedure of cautiously docking this ship, which we're gonna try a little bit quicker this time. Now remember, since we have relatively equal... I want to say force push. Power propulsion in every direction. If I hold this for 3 seconds, I can then hold S for 3 seconds. And it should balance this out, because all that powers is equals. Let's go ahead gently now and maneuver you into place. Whoa, that's a bit fast. Whoop it a bit lock. Cool. And we didn't explode, so that's always a massive plus. Let's go ahead. Production. You built all those lickety-split. That's awesome. But let's go ahead and do that program again. Yeah. And script too complex, my arse. Run. There we go. Ta-da! And now that should have moved some more motors into our ship. Of course, I don't want these on us because it's just taking up space. We want welders. And while we're here, I'm going to drag in some solar cells too, since I know we're probably going to need those. Is that... how many is that? I can't even see the bloody number. Okay, it was 1,900 of them, let's say. So, just so we have those in our cargo container, so we shouldn't have to come back once all is said and done. Go ahead and get ourselves away from there and start maneuvering ourselves back to finish up those last lovely little buggers. And by that, I mean those things I can never remember the name of. Thrusters! Atmospheric thrusters. There we go. Such a simple gosh darn name. I can never remember it. All right, and back we go. Lickety split like. Overshot a little bit there. by the way, you've probably seen Zoc playing a game called Hellion. I turned on my inertial dampers there for a second. That could have been horrible. They were good enough to send me a key for Hellion, but I just couldn't find myself getting into it. I guess maybe I was like, I just want to build at this moment, and I wasn't really getting that, like, hey, let's quick build. It was a lot of move this piece to connect it to this piece. But what I did like in Hellion was the interior stuff, where it's like, fix this component by unplugging this and shifting that, and it was like, oh, this is very enjoyable. But I haven't found anything to really make a video on it yet, because often I try to show building stuff, or, you know, I'll go on like this while building up stuff. I haven't found that in that game, and a lot of it seems like it's, well, even a bit slower than this sometimes. Also, I will say, I found it more difficult to judge speeds and things in that, and found myself in a spot of bother there when trying to get up to something else and match my speed to it. Alrighty, so we did that, got those thrusters up and running. Let's hop out of this. It's drifting very slowly, but I think if it hits this wall, it might explode terribly because of that glitch that's been killing us, so let's hop back in here and slow it up all the way. Ah, need to be in first person for me to figure out the movements. There we go, that's pretty much stationary. Moving a tiny bit. Let's go ahead now and go to you. Boop, and select atmospheric thrusters. So, should be... oh, there's still two of them unfinished somewhere. Son of a Don Quixote. Anyway, let's go ahead and save that so they're all on there. Turn them all on and off again. Coolio, and then where the hell are those two that we didn't finish? Oh, they're over there. Brilliant. Hello, giant rock. And coming up on our last two thrusters, which of course we did add to that group and shut off, so we shouldn't have to worry about them causing us any grief, or should I say spinning weirdly, when we complete them. So that's one done, and any second now. Oh, come on, I picked up so many motors, you're telling me you still don't have enough for that, huh? Dag nabbit, that is quite annoying. Let's see, how many did we fall short, I wonder? Oh, come on, stop ship, there we go. And we're of course going to have to go ahead and press the wrong button. Go to here, still can't drag it down to the hotbar, that's so gosh darn annoying. It's down to the hotbar with you, there we go. How far off are we from completion? Oh my goodness, it was large steel tubes. Well, that's lickety-split easy enough. Just fly over here and grab some large steel tubes and hopefully not hit the wall too quickly. Ah, right, they weigh a lot, don't they? Drop you off. Can I carry more now? Barely. Blip. And now I just need 8 more of you. Thank you very much. Now let's go ahead and drop them off, and job should be done in milliseconds then. So there we go, and one little dab of the welder. Wow, that was weird to see the smoke go past it, but there we go. Everything is now successfully welded up, and I think that'll be it for this episode. It was actually quite successful. If we didn't really accomplish a whole lot, I found it interesting just because, of course, we're in a giant ship that's moving through the sky at high speeds. And I don't even know how far away we were from the monolith at the beginning, but hey, I'd say we've made a little bit of a distance, haven't we? Shall we do one jump just to say, hey, look, we did cover some serious distance before we end the episode? I think that would be interesting, so let's go ahead and connect this ship up to that docking port. We'll do a quick save, and then we'll jump the ship just as far as we can to see how close we do get to the Mars. I almost called it the moon, but it is not. It is the Mars. There we go. Locked in place. And into the bridge we go. You know, I'm not even afraid of venting this at this moment. Because I get the feel, oh, it actually did push me back. I was amazed. I was expecting it to like try to push me back from much farther away. Warning, room's depressurized. Yeah, I've made a mess of that. Let's go ahead and hop in the seat. Set our coordinates for our jump drive to the monolith. Select, coolio. Let's go ahead and turn all of our jump drives on. I just had them there, didn't I? There we go. On. Okay, and all of you are set to like silly distances, so let's just, yeah, there we go. That should, well, this is the main one. As long as we fire that one, it should go to where, however far it can. And let's just double check that is main coolio. Let's do a quick save, which is taking a very long time. Okay, there we go. And let's jump it. Let's see how far we get at number 8. Jumpers cannot be, what does that say? Jump into natural gravity. Yeah, but is it really natural gravity? It's just near natural gravity, isn't it? Are you serious? You're gonna stop it? I guess we would have the range. I guess we would be there in this episode. Well, screw it. We're going there. It is 1,699 kilometers away. Let's go ahead and let's go. Remove 1,600. So 1,100. Oh, it has to be a number between 0 and 100. I forgot. It's a stupid system. And that honestly says it can only go 300. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. If that's all of them. Whatever. We're just going to do one blind jump then. Screw it all. I saved. If everything goes completely to hell, ta-da, we can fall back. It shouldn't, though. It should just be to 300 and something, according to that. Yeah. Did we just go the wrong way? I feel like we just went the wrong way. We just went the wrong way. That's not right. Son of a bitch, I was in the wrong chair.